Okay, guys, it's been about 10 minutes, and I just received an email saying my personalized sewing pattern is ready. I did get one email already just telling me that, you know, I ordered it. That was at 10:17, and now at 10:24, I guess 7 minutes later, they've actually finished drafting it for me. So that's nice. And I believe this gives me a link to go find it. Actually, it's just in the email. So I thought I'd have to go back to the website. And you can go back to the website if you made an account and it's saved there. Otherwise, else, if you're just a guest, they'll just email it to you. So here we go. It looks like they sent me three files. This one has the file extension .pdf. This is file extension .dxf. And here's another PDF. I think that the two PDF ones are sewing instructions, one in English and German, maybe Russian. I don't really know. All I know is that I do need the DXF file. That's the whole point of this project. So downloading it on my computer, it's saved to my downloads folder. I have no idea where you're saving it to your computer, so I'll let you figure that out. And I'm going to go to CLO and import that guy. I actually don't need these patterns here. I was working on something else, and I don't know why they're there. And I don't even think I don't mind this avatar, but let's give her the right size. So let's see here. I guess it looks like I have Fifi right now. I'm going to double click back to avatar. I'm going to go to size, and I think I'll do Missy straight. And I believe I got a size 10. So I'm going to double click that guy. So you may want to use your own avatar that you work so hard creating. That's totally fine. But you definitely need to keep in mind that you want your avatar measurements to be similar to whatever measurements you created for that 2D pattern. Okay, that's definitely part of our challenge. I don't need this library anymore, so I just hit the little arrow so the tab went back. So you can see we have our library tab, history, and modular configurator. So I don't need it now, so I want it out of the way. I left my object browser tab open and my property editor because I do believe we will be using it. I'm going to pan to get this image down a little bit lower. It looks like it defaulted having the axis like cross right in the middle. So to pan, I'm going to push my scroll wheel on my mouse and click and drag just so it's lower. Okay, I'm ready to import my pattern. Woo, here we go. File, import, add. Okay, because we're adding. We don't want to get rid of our avatar. We're going to keep it. So import, add. Write that down if you forget. What file extension do we want to add? We would like to add a DXF file. So click that guy. Here's the hard part. Now we got to remember, where did we save that file? I saved mine in my downloads. I kind of got lucky. It just defaulted to downloads. I don't know if you'll get that lucky, but you have to find where you saved it. Okay, here it is. What a horrible file name, right? 4691. If I was smarter, I would probably rename that something easier to know what it is, but oh well. There it is, .dxf. I'm going to open it. Oh my gosh, so many questions. Okay, autoscale, sometimes that scares me, but I do see it's 100%. Be careful because I have imported patterns where it says it'll scale it to 1,000%, and that's terrible. We don't want that because it's going to be huge. So I guess autoscale only because it's at 100%. If I say inches, yeah, maybe I'll change it to inch. Make sure it's 100%. I don't really care if it's rotated because I can always do that later. Sure, bring in any annotations. I don't know. All this stuff, I'm just going to kind of leave as default. I don't really care. And I'll just say okay. I might have messed up on my pattern scale. You know what? I changed it to inches, and I think it was in centimeters. So I might have to actually delete this. Sometimes it's fun to do things wrong. Okay, let's try that again. I don't even think it defaulted. It imported it. Let me try again. File, import, add, DXF. Let's try this one more time. Okay, let's just do auto scale, huh? Let's try that. Okay. That works better. Yeah, that's right. The pattern was in centimeters now that I think about it, and I know I'm working in inches. So when I switch it to inches, it just didn't work. So let's see if this is better. I should also probably remind everyone I am working on an older Mac laptop. CLO is best run on the high-powered gaming PCs. It also does really run very well on Macs, to be honest with you. I think just because my computer, it's getting pretty old and I have lots of things saved on it. I should probably do a cleaning. Hopefully your file is opening a little bit quicker than mine. Okay, cool. Here it is. It's open. I think for now, I'm just going to click and drag and scooch it to the side over here so I can actually place the pattern pieces where I want them. Okay, so, oh wow, they even have names. This must be all the annotations, having all those names on them. Awesome. Okay, now, if you would actually like to name your pattern pieces in CLO, you will actually need to select your pattern piece and then look at the property editor window. And you'll see under information it says name. So CLO went ahead and named this guy Shape2D. You might want to change the name. I'm going to pan by holding my scroll wheel. Looks like the name here is Front. So I could just double click and type in Front. And so I use the property editor. And that's really how you want to name your pattern pieces so that later on when you print them, it identifies the name here and it'll print the name on it for when you want to print. These are all annotations. It's another way to name it, but not a very effective way because it's not really connected with the software knowing that it's the name. It kind of just thinks it's just artwork on your thing or drawings. I don't know how to explain it. But anyways, to name your pattern pieces, I recommend going to Property Editor and naming them here. I'd also like to just bring up, looks like this pattern piece does not have seam allowance. No big deal. We don't need seam allowance when using CLO, but if you did want to later go print this out, you'll probably want to add your seam allowance, and there is a seam allowance tool. I believe it looks like a little sewing machine, maybe? No, maybe not. Let me find it. Again, my computer's a little small. Oh, no, that's not. Oh, here it is. No, it actually looks like a sloper. There it is, seam allowance. If you click that guy, right now it just has this one pattern piece selected. If I just click and drag over all of them, then it adds seam allowance. And if you see in the property editor, it defaults to 0.345. I think that's some weird conversion reason why it does that. All you have to do is change it to what you want. I usually like half an inch, so I type in 0.5, and now it's half an inch on all of them. If for some reason, you know, sometimes you want the hem a little bit longer, you can click just the hem and, oh, look, first let me try it one more time. Click, uh-oh, let me try that again. There we are. Maybe these are too close. I'm just gonna move them right now. They're overlapping. Ooh, we have way too many shapes happening as well. Okay, so this needs to be cleaned up a little bit. So again, this is part of the challenge. You're gonna get strange patterns from the factory or, you know, free internet websites, and they aren't gonna be perfect and you're just gonna have to deal with them. Okay, so let me go back to show you that seam allowance tool. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna click on this segment. I'm gonna hold shift to select another segment. So two segments are selected. Again, I did make the seam allowance half an inch, but I want to change this one to 1 inch because it's the hem. So that's how you can do it, and you can see it left half inch at other places. I just wanted to bring that to your attention, and for those of you guys that later would actually like to print these out and sew them up. Okay, now I need to turn this guy around. Could you figure out how to do that without me telling you? Of course, there's more than one way. What happens if we right-click? I feel like in CLO, that's always my first go-to, just right-click. What tools do they have? And here we go. I can easily just rotate it. I guess I'm going to have to do counter, you know, clockwise or counterclockwise twice to, at the 90 degrees because 90 plus 90 is 180 degrees, and there we go. Okay, so now it's upright. It's not upside down anymore, so that's good. What else do I need to do with this guy? Another way to rotate it, by the way, is right here. Do you see? I just took my mouse and I hovered over this little thing. And then you can click and drag. And if I hold shift, it's supposed to lock. Oh, it doesn't look like shift's helping. There it goes. Yeah, it's supposed to lock on like 45 degrees or 90 degrees. But I think in this case, the easiest way was just to right click and do rotate. That's why you got exactly 180 degrees. I thought that was a little bit easier. And there might be other ways to rotate in the software. Honestly, feel free to share if you guys know of a better way. Let's see here. Okay, we got some trims. That's for our back neckline, our front neckline. We got our sleeve. Okay, so it looks like the back piece and our trims. Now again, there was that weird outline. I wonder if I'm gonna have to delete that on all the pieces. Get rid of you. Yeah. See this like red. This must be a different layer. I'm not exactly sure yet, but I just know I don't need it. It's a little messy. I'm gonna get rid of it. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna click my back pattern piece. I'm gonna hold shift. I'm also grabbing the front band, and I'm gonna hold shift and grab the back band. I'm gonna right click, and I wanna rotate these guys. I'm gonna click counterclockwise. I'm gonna right click. Now, when I right click, I should make a point. I'm not right clicking on the background because a different menu came up and it deselected my items. When I right click, I was very mindful that my mouse was hovering. Oh dear. I guess I gotta zoom in here. Holding shift. Okay, it's selected. My mouse is on top of something that's selected. So I'm gonna get very different right click menu than if I right clicked on the background, right? Okay, let me try that again. I just did something. Okay, here we go. Rotate counterclockwise one more time. There we go. Okay, I think we're good. Okay, I don't even know what I did. I think I changed my setting on accident to not see my pattern piece, to make them invisible, which is fine. So let's fix that. Okay, I'm gonna select you. Okay, you are selected. Okay, I believe this may be under information. Let me see here. This kind of stuff, I'm a little rusty on. What did I do? I'm gonna have to like go in this video and figure out what I did. Okay, let me right click on it. That's odd. I wonder what I did.